Hey, Space Lab. My name's Caleb Scharf, and I'm Director of Astrobiology at Columbia University, and I'm here today to answer your questions. The first question is this. If you were standing near the event horizon of a black hole, and someone pointed a beam of gamma rays at you, would they remain gamma rays or turn into something else? The first thing to realize is that gamma ray is really just a label that we use for high-energy electromagnetic radiation. So that's stuff that's more energetic than even X-rays, and it's kind of an arbitrary thing. So what happens if I shine gamma rays down towards someone standing close to the event horizon of a black hole? Well, the answer really comes out of Einstein's general relativity. Einstein's relativity tells us that space and time are distorted around mass, and light moving into that distorted space-time will get changed. And in this case, as it barrels down into the gravity well, it will get boosted to higher and higher energies. It will get what's called blue-shifted. So from my point of view, standing at the event horizon, the gamma rays just hit me as even more powerful gamma rays than they originally were. That's really all that happens. The next question is this. If the universe is expanding and galaxies are moving farther apart, then why is it that the Milky Way and Andromeda galaxies are on a collision course? This is a really good question, and we have to understand a couple of things in order to answer it. And the first is that the expansion of the universe, the expansion of space itself, is actually, on small scales, relatively gentle. It's more of an undertow that's stretching out space all around us. Now, why are there any things in this universe at all? Why are the planets and stars and galaxies in the first place? Because if space is expanding, how can anything hold together? And the answer is really that gravity, on small enough scales, can overcome this undertow of expanding space. So Andromeda and the Milky Way just happen to start out close enough to each other in the universe that their mass and their gravitational attraction to each other is enough to overcome that undertow and gradually bring them together, have them fall towards each other. So that in 4 or 5 billion years' time, they're actually going to collide and they're going to merge into something new that's really pulled itself out of this cosmic expansion. The next question is this. Why do the planets and asteroids in our solar system orbit the Sun in a flat orbit, essentially in a plane? And why do we see the same thing in other structures like galaxies where the stars orbit in a great plane around the center? The answer to this question really comes in two basic pieces, although it gets a lot more complex. The first piece is that the universe tends to like to preserve or conserve rotation, specifically a quantity we call angular momentum. So angular momentum is just a product of the mass of something that's rotating or spinning and the speed of that rotation or spin. So for example, the Earth has a particular angular momentum. And nature doesn't like to change angular momentum once it's there. And this means that once something has a bit of spin, it tends to stay that way unless it loses or gains energy. So that's the first piece of the answer. The second piece is all to do with the specific ways in which things like solar systems and galaxies actually form in the first place. So if we take our solar system, it formed out of a clump of gas and dust in a nebula. And it formed because gravity kind of took over and shrunk and collapsed this clump of gas and dust under its own weight. But what if it's rotating a little bit to start with? What if there's a little bit of motion? What happens is it's easier for gravity to collapse this structure along the axis of rotation than it is in the other direction. And you can kind of think of it like centrifugal or centripetal forces. Gravity has to battle those in one direction, but along the spin axis it doesn't, and stuff can just fall down flat. So in a sense, there's a natural tendency for things to collapse into a shape a bit like a fried egg. We see this in our solar system, we see it in other structures like disks of matter around black holes, and we also see it on the biggest scales in the great spiral galaxies that populate our universe. Thanks for all your great questions. If you have more questions, please leave them in the comments below for the next expert to answer.